Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss MCQs from your current affairs perspective. So today is 30th October. So let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, Million Farmer School is implemented by which state government? So the answer is B, Uttar Pradesh. So it is before you. So there is no point of saying that I hope answer is B, because obviously it is shown on your screen. So Kisan Pathshala Yojana of UP government, also being called the Million Farmers School. It is basically an extension and outreach program to connect the agricultural department, scientific and technical staff with state's farming community. So the interesting part of this scheme is its design, that is campaign mode and module based, and time. Just during the cropping season. So the Pathshalas are in the form of a 5-day teaching module adapted to each of the state's 9 agroclimatic zones. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Smart Cities mission. First, it is a centrally sponsored scheme. Second, it will be implemented by a special purpose vehicle created at the city level. So we have to choose the correct answer. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So the answer is, the Smart Cities mission is an innovative and new initiative by the government of India. So it aims to basically drive economic growth and improve the quality of life of people living in cities. By focusing upon we can say revamp of cities with the every facility available to them. So smart cities focus on the most on their most pressing needs and on the greatest opportunities to improve lives. So strategy is pan city initiative, in which at least one smart solution is applied citywide. So develop areas by area step by step, 3 models of area based development: retrofitting, redevelopment and greenfield. So core infrastructure elements are adequate at water supply, assured electricity supply, sanitation including solid waste management, efficient urban mobility and public transport, and affordable housing especially for the poor, robust IT connectivity and digitization, good governance especially e-governance and citizen participation, and sustainable environment, safety and security of citizens particularly women, children and elderly, and health and education. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Indian Ocean Dipole. First, the Indian Ocean Dipole is the Indian Ocean counterpart part of the Pacific, El Nino and La Nina. Second, the shifting pools of warm cool water contribute to variations in rainfall and storm activities of many countries surrounding the Indian Ocean. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So the answer is C. So Indian Ocean Dipole effect is basically a counterpart of El Nino and La Nina. So it is basically we can say this Indian Ocean, the term dipole means two poles. So it is, as is clear from name, so or two areas of differences. So IOD measures differences in the SSTs between the Arabian Sea and the Eastern Indian Ocean south of Indonesia. So you can read about it by pausing the video and you can check more details. So we will not be focusing upon the details because we have a limited time period to complete the video in a time framework. And next question is, fourth question is, consider the following statements related to European Union. First, European Union consists of 7 primary institutions. Second, European Parliament is one of the legislative organ of the European Union along with the Council of European Union. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So European Council, it is a collective body that defines the European Union's overall political direction and priorities. So it comprises of heads of state or government of the European Union member states along with the president of European Council and the President of European Commission, and the High Representative of the Union for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy also takes part in its meetings. So it was established as an informal summit in 1975, that the European Council was formalized as an institution in 2009 after the Treaty of Lisbon. The decisions are adopted by consensus, the decisions that are taken in summit. So European Parliament is basically directly elected by European Union citizens aged 18 years or older. So together with the Council of European Union, also known as the Council, it exercises the legislative function of the European Union. So Council of European Union, it is part of the essentially bicameral European Union legislature and represents the executive government ministers of the European Union member states. Now let's move on to the more details. So you can check the more details by pausing the video, because it is difficult to discuss all the details, so in detail explanation is given. So comprehensive explanation is there, so you can read about the comprehensive explanation. Now is, consider the following statements related to strategic petroleum reserve in India. First, the construction of strategic crude oil storage facilities is being managed by Indian Strategic Petroleum Reserves Limited, a special purpose vehicle which is wholly owned subsidiary of Oil Industry Development Board with the, under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. And the second is the crude oil storages are constructed in underground rock caverns and are located only on west coast of India. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A, that is first only. Second is not correct because some facilities are in South India also. And basically 5 million metric tons of strategic crude oil storages are to be built. Its purpose is to ensure energy security. And 3 locations are there, that is namely Visakhapatnam, Mangalore and Padur. So South India, clearly all these locations are in South India. It is these strategic crude oil storage facilities they are to be managed by Indian Strategic Petroleum Reserves Limited, and it is a special purpose vehicle created for the purpose of so Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas is basically the body which controls Oil Industry and Development Board, which basically will be under which Indian Strategic Petroleum Reserves Limited is set up a special purpose vehicle. Now let's move to the next statement. Next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Amrut Mission. So the mission has replaced Jawaharlal Nehru Urban Renewal Mission. Second, it aims to provide infrastructure for providing universal water and sewage services. So friends, the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So mission, basically it is Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation. So full form is this. So mission will focus on following thrust areas, that is water supply, sewage and septage management, stormwater drainage to reduce flooding, and non-motorized urban transport, green space parks. So 500 cities have been selected under Amrut. The category of cities that have been selected under Amrut is given below. So all cities and towns with a population of over 1 lakh with notified municipalities as per census 2011, including cantonment boards, that is civilian areas, and then all capital cities, towns of states, UTs not covered in above, all cities, town classified as heritage cities by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs under the Heritage Scheme, and then 13 cities and towns on the stem of the main rivers with the population of above 75,000 and less than 1 lakh. So basically this is comprehensive. List is comprehensive. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following is not the memorandum of understanding signed between India and Saudi Arabia recently? So A, Strategic Partnership Council Agreement, B, Renewable Energy, C, Civil Aviation, D, Membership of OIC. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is D. It is quite simple. Basically, Organization of Islamic Countries, OIC, India is not part of it, because India is not a Muslim, mainly Muslim country. So name of the agreement, there are many various agreements, you can pause and can read about it in detail. So this has been picked up from your PIB, that is Public Information Bureau. So list is comprehensive. Next is, Chicago Convention senior news is related to A, International Civil Aviation Organization, B, IMF, C, World Bank, D, none of the above. So friends, the answer is A, that is International Civil Aviation Organization. So you might be aware of the fact that recently Prime Minister was the Prime Minister of India was denied to enter the Indian Pakistan airspace. So that's why this is in news. So India has approached ICAO after Pakistan denied permission for PM Modi to use its airspace. So background is this. So International Civil Aviation Organization, it is a UN specialized agency established by states in 1944 to manage the administration and governance of the Convention on International Civil Aviation, Chicago Convention. So functions are given here, so you can read about it and can pause the video to read about it in detail. Now let's move to the next question is, Copernicus program on Earth observation program is implemented by A, ISRO, B, ESA, that C, NASA, D, JAXA. So friends, answer is European Space Agency, that is B. So Earth Observation Program, it is the most ambitious Earth Observation Program to date. So it will provide accurate, timely and easily accessible information to improve the management of the environment, understand and mitigate the effects of climate change and ensure civil society. So Copernicus is the new name for the Global Monitoring for Environment and Security Program, previously known as GMES. So it is headed by the European Commission in partnership with the European Space Agency. So services provided by Copernicus, that is land management, the marine environment, atmosphere, emergency response, security and climate change. So Sentinel is basically it is developing a new family of satellites called Sentinels, specifically for the operational needs of the Copernicus program. Now let's move to the next question and the last question of the day, that is INS Bas, seen in news, is A, submarine, B, southernmost air station, C, aircraft carrier, D, none of the above. So friends, answer is B. So INS Bas is basically the southernmost air station of the Indian Armed Forces, located at Campbell Bay on the Great Nicobar Island, the southernmost and the largest island of the Nicobar Island, and this island is also the location of Indra Point and is less than 250 km by sea from Banda Aceh in Indonesia. So primary function is to help build maritime domain awareness by providing information via airborne surveillance using aircraft and unmanned aerial vehicles. So location has been described as India's window into the East and Southeast Asia and is in close vicinity of the 6-degree channel, also called the Great Channel, one of the Indian Ocean's busiest shipping lines, carrying strategic cargo to East Asian countries. So it is also close to Strait of Malacca. So it is a part of Andaman and Nicobar Island, the only tri-services formation of the Indian Armed Forces that was started in 2001. So friends, this is all about today's discussion, and if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, these are some details about us. So this is our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen. So you can visit our Telegram channel and can join it. On this Telegram channel, we have more than 14,000 subscribers. So these students, what they are able to do, they are able to access various public services that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation. So if you want to be part of these students and want to access our various services, then you can join our Telegram channel, and the link will be also provided in the description box. So friends, this is our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in. So the link of which is also provided in the description box. So you can visit our website as well for accessing various type of public resources that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation. And lastly, if you have any doubts, queries, you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 89689-20720. So friends, this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.